Since the 1970s, carbon dioxide from natural geologic deposits has been injected into oil-bearing reservoirs to extend their producing life.
Today in the U.S., 2.5 billion cubic feet per day of carbon dioxide is bought and sold. Now, of that 2.5 billion cubic feet per day, 94% of that market is the production of large quantities of CO2 that are purchased, transported, and injected into the ground in order to produce crude oil from enhanced oil recovery.
Anthropogenic CO2 used in place of natural CO2 for enhanced oil recovery can help reduce our carbon footprint.
In terms of the individual project economics, there's a lot out there which is interesting because it can be quite profitable. One of the things that you would look at would be enhanced oil recovery, where you take CO2 from, let's say, a coal-fired power station and you put it underground in an oil field or a gas field, which is in decline. And what that does is it increases the pressure in those fields and it helps you take more out faster. And that provides a nice economic incentive for a company to invest in these technology.
The current techniques used for enhanced oil recovery can be used to store anthropogenic CO2 permanently underground. Putting CO2 into underground geologic reservoirs is called geologic CO2 sequestration, or carbon capture and storage. The CO2 could be stored in depleted oil reservoirs, deep unminable coal seams, and deep saline reservoirs. Each ton of this stored carbon creates a credit that can be sold on the market. In this way, the cost of implementing sequestration can be financed through the sale of carbon credits.
Apache Canada Limited is injecting anthropogenic CO2 into the ground in northwestern Alberta for enhanced oil recovery. That CO2 is going to remain under the ground after the project is finished. There are many economic and environmental benefits to this.
I think it will play a major role. There's great interest in geological sequestration, where companies who emit carbon dioxide can capture that carbon dioxide and pipe it to a geological reservoir and bury it in the ground.
Now, as we're looking at building new power plants, we need to seriously consider what the environmental ramifications of those plants are going to be. We're going to approach the reduction of greenhouse gas from a number of different angles. Part of that matrix is going to be looking at carbon capture and sequestration technologies,